Well, hello there, and welcome back to Let's Play The World Ends With You. Well, the grand finale. Last time, we fought Kitanichi, and right after that, Joshua showed up. And that's where we left off. Protect Shibuya. Well, shite.
Your good is gone.
In this battle, Kitanichi fused with Joshua and, well, crap. Let me out of here. If you can break out of the bubble in time, he will bite you for massive damage. This is the battle that you want the Cunt Destroyer deck for, really? Because you freaking neck. You can't just, well, because you can't just run around, dash around invincibly. And every time you get one of these screens where one of the party members where one of the party members does a fusion thing with you, you've got to quickly press the corresponding button on the D-pad. Oh crap, can you stop this already? Let light sink. And every time you press the button correctly, you get more power poke and more powerful. And then we get to do the massive fusion for the finale.
Done.
And on ultimate difficulty you can get the Black Venus from the guy. At least I think that was ultimate difficulty. It might have been hard difficulty, but I don't think so. You? Don't you mean I? Indeed, why does Kitanichi have a timer? And it's at like 2 minutes. Cool. So Joshua is the composer. Okay. You're a quick one, aren't you, Niku? To be fair, he doesn't have the almighty power of being the game's player, and therefore seeing cutscenes that go on in people's memories. Welp. In other words, the dude who defeated, who single-handedly defeated Minamimoto in the, near the river, was this guy. Huh. So do we get a final battle against Joshua? Yes? Yes? Come on, let's beat up that sissy. Welp, that's one hell of a stalker. You've still been keeping some of our memories, yes. Now they were taken way before the entry fee was collected. So there's that. Now we finally know the truth about what happened that day in Uragawa. Let's have a look.
Blew it. What? What the hell?
That one sentence pretty much sums up the ending. Oh well.
Same streets. Same crowds too. Yeah. Shibuya hasn't changed a bit. But still, I don't think I can forgive you yet. You don't see it, but those few weeks were very hard for me. Learning to trust people. Having that trust broken. Finding out the town I pegged is small and stifling and empty. Wasn't any of those things.
Let me in! Tell me what you're thinking!
Only by allowing strangers in can we find new ways to be ourselves.
I'm scared! Scared of getting a second chance!
Listen up, Bones. Cause I ain't asking twice. Please, help me. You gotta help me save
her. Neku, that's the first time you used my name.
But Neku, I thought you couldn't afford to lose. Give up on yourself, and you give up on the world.
You ain't my partner anymore, man. You're my friend.
Once you see the real me, will we still be friends?
I'm glad I met you guys. You made me pick up on things I probably would have just gone on ignoring. Trust your partner. And I do. I can't forgive you, but I trust you. You took care of things, right? Otherwise, Shibuya would be gone, and my world with it. Hey, did I mention? I've got friends now. We're getting together for the first time in a week. See you there.
And that's it, man. Yeah. Well. It appears Shibuya has not been destroyed, but... What the f... Seriously. Oh, hey! Rhyme's back alive too. Or is this all just a fever dream? Knowing this game, it might very well be. But what about Shiki and her lady friend, whose name I forgot? Oh well. Directly after the credits, the post-game begins just like so. Well, I'll be continuing straight on into the next episode. If you want to watch the post-game and get a few more answers out of the game. That's something I really hate about the game. Instead of presenting the plot in a nice way, be it visually or in text, during a conversation there is in text. Instead of that, they have a freaking explanation that you can only access in post-game. Yeah. You have to go really out of your way to get that explanation from the game. Those present boxes I've been collecting every once in a while during the game are part of that. Tis a thing. I hold back on my opinion of the game as a whole. I think I've said enough near the beginning, how the combat system sucks. I just lost my train of thought for a moment because I read the credits and noticed freaking Pinky and Rhyme are voiced by the same person. Disturbing. Oh well. Oh well, in case you don't want to watch the post-game, well, I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play of The World Ends With You. I hope you enjoyed it for whatever it's worth. Tis the thing. That's all I have to say about it. Oh well.
You know, This mess is gonna have repercussions upstairs. But hey, at least things are back to normal, right? What? You seem down. Hey, it's their world. They get to decide what to do with it. We just... Some folks just don't take no for an answer.